Have you ever had to stop a tapping operation right there while the tap was fully engaged in the hole? Boy, there can be nothing worse than having to try to figure out how to retract that tap back out of the hole. Do I have to loosen my collet knot? Do I have to try to engage my drawbar and jog the head? In CNC applications, this can be very challenging. Well, that's the exact scenario we're going to take a look at today. Here we've drilled a couple holes, and now we're coming in and we're tapping. On the third hole, you're going to see we're going to perform a reset command to stop in the middle of the hole. Once reset is pressed, now the machine is stopped. From here, we can switch to our jog screen to get access to our retract function. Simply expand your soft keys over and press the soft key for retract. This will allow us to now jog the machine spindle in a plus direction, and the machine will actually move synchronized in both spindle and Z to retract the tap. If your machine doesn't actually have the ability of jogging the spindle, you can use your Z-axis mode to jog out. You do have to select the WCS MCS button and make sure it's in WCS mode. Once the tap's pulled up far enough, you can now jog the machine to a safe position and decide what comes next. In our case, we're going to come back and we're going to continue to tap these holes. By switching the machine to auto mode, I can do a mid-program restart with our block search function. Simply arrow to the line you want to start from and choose block search. Now select start search. If the system sees that there's multiple operations, you'll choose the operation you want to start from. Now, by pressing cycle start, the system will scan to that starting point, set up all modal commands that occurred before this, and continue tapping our holes. Now, in the next scenario, we're going to take a look at not performing a reset command, but actually e-stopping the machine in the middle of tapping a hole. So we're going to re-tap the first two holes we've already cut, and we're going to finish tapping the third hole. Now we're moving into the fourth hole, and this is the hole we're going to e-stop. So as you watch, we perform an e-stop, the machine is stopped immediately. At this point, we got to switch over to jog mode like we did before, but we have to reset our drives. So we turn the system on, and now we're just going to repeat what we did before. We're going to expand our soft keys over, select the retract function, and now we're going to choose our spindle command and jog the machine in a plus direction. If you need to, because of the e-stop, you may have to feed enable the axes again. Once the machine's been retracted high enough where the tap is no longer engaged in the threads, you can now switch over to a standard jog mode and jog the Z to a clearance position. Once the tap's in a safe location, we can now start the program again. We'll do the same operation we did before, which is a mid-program restart, and we're going to finish tapping all of our holes. Once we've completed the tapping operation, we'll go back and see what the quality of the thread looks like. Now let's go check to see what our threads look like. So not only do we save our tap, but we even saved the part. It's amazing to see how simple SINUMERIK truly is.